Sebastian goes in the morning and goes to the seafloor and then explores and takes samples.
And on the ROV camera, you can see dark blue water starting to lighten as it starts to surface. And you're waiting and you're waiting for your samples.
The ROV comes in, and then Professor Bright takes the animals out of the biobox and she handles to the people or to the person that is interested in the animals or in the rocks or in water samples. Then they immediately go to the lab and start processing.
And then it stays busy, but it goes more quiet because people start to get really concentrated and working.
We're all sort of busy bees doing our separate things. And I think it's really fun to sort of move around your colleagues, to divvy up samples together, to say, oh, you know, you want this limpet, I'll give you this one if you exchange me a rock.
So I spent 3 years of my life actually looking into the genetic code of Rhyptia. And I think this is like an experience that I will carry through for the rest of my life, to get my hands dirty and actually catch this gigantic worm with my hands.
Yeah, I mean, that's part of like our desire and our curiosity-driven science, to find out like how different aspects of this ecosystem are functioning, from the viruses to the microbes and all the way to the higher levels of the food chain down there.
One of the experiments that I find extremely interesting is trying to explore what those symbionts are doing when they leave the host and what they do in their free living state.
The high-pressure incubations of Rhyptia, for example, or the in vitro fertilization experiments.
Finding out the temperature range where little tiny crustaceans, copepods, can survive.
I think the respirometer that the Gerges lab is using is really incredible. They're able to, you know, measure the input and output of these dissolved gases. Clarissa looks at marine snow. So she designed and then 3D printed these cassettes to rotate to keep these marine particles in suspension. And I just think it's the coolest thing.
One of the most important things also is that you meet people from different disciplines and to let people explain to you what their goal is and what they want to find out.
When other people have samples that would keep them up to midnight, you can, you know, pitch in, collaborate, and through doing that you learn a lot about sort of different methods that people use and learn from, you know, not only the hard skills of science but also the soft skills of the creativity, the precision, the attention to detail.
And I think this is like something special about going to cruise expeditions, because everyone is interested in different aspects of deep sea. And then you get to know a lot about the whole ecosystem, not only your specific subject.